Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get us started, and I'm sure we'll still have a few continue to come in as we progress. But good afternoon. My name is Blair Boone-Migura. I am the founder and the executive director of the Art Song Preservation Society. And welcome today to the first, our inaugural event for the summer season. I'm delighted to have you with us virtually. For those who don't know, we historically present these programs, our master classes and recitals, at the Manhattan School of Music on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. And obviously, due to the pandemic, things have changed, at least over the past year. Beginning in 2020, at the end of 2020, we began to shift to a virtual model that we're going to continue through with this summer. So our entire summer series will be presented online virtually, but we are looking forward to returning to the Manhattan School of Music for the next season. So this is surely not the last time that we'll be seen virtually, because what we've learned over the past year is that we do have those who are very interested in us continuing on with some sort of virtual component to our programming. So we hear you and we acknowledge it, and we're going to continue to make sure that we, in addition to our live presentations, present some virtual options as well. So before we get started today, I just want to say, feel free to drop into the comment box any questions that you have. You should have received the music that will be presented today by our talented singers, but if you haven't, I'm going to go ahead and put that in the comment box as well, so that you have the musical scores, because I know that Mark Markham wants you to be as involved in the process and get to see some of the behind the scenes. So if you are musically literate, it's going to be very interesting for you to have the music there with you. I would like, before we begin, to thank Creative Engagement. So our Summer of Song Festival this year is made possible in part from funds that we received from the Creative Engagement Grant. This is a grant that is supported by the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs in partnership with the City Council and the New York State Council of the Arts, with the support of our governor. So thank you to the Creative Engagement Grant, and thank you to LMCC, Lower Manhattan Cultural Communities, which helped to support this initiative. And they've been a long supporter of ours, so we're very grateful for that. And obviously, I want to thank our guest artist today, Mark Markham, who is one of our advisory board members. He's taught many master classes for us in the past. All of them have been stellar. He's presented recitals, both solo piano recitals and singing recitals, recitals with singers for us. And he's judged our vocal competition. So we are very much indebted to him and to the other great teachers that we have who make up our advisory board and teach these wonderful master classes. So if you're a singer or if you're a teacher of singing and you're interested, don't hesitate to reach out to me, because I would be happy to get you involved in our programs. So with that, I'd like to present our guest artist, Mark Markham, who many of you may know as the collaborative partner for nearly 20 years with the legendary Jessye Norman. But in addition to that, he's played for a long list of other talented singers like Janae Bridges, Jennifer O'Loughlin, Lea Crescetto, Derek Lee Reagan, and that's just to name a few. And he is an amazing solo pianist as well, both in the area of jazz and classical, and improvisations. And he plays with orchestra, so there's really a limitless ability from our guest artist today. And we're delighted to have him with you to present these talented singers and show you a little bit behind the scenes of what it takes to collaborate and make an ensemble between the singer and the pianist. So with that, without further ado, I give you Mark Markham and the amazing singers on today's Collaboration and Ensemble Masterclass.
You can tell that I have a very enthusiastic audience, even though they might be nervous that they're singing today. So, Blair was talking about doing these classes online. 6 months ago, the only way we could do this pretty much was to have a singer on the computer with me looking at them over Zoom and working with them that way. Once or twice, if people were lucky enough to have a pianist with whom they worked so that they didn't have to worry about, you know, viruses and stuff like that, they could actually be together. But then it was even more complicated trying to balance out their sound because it takes too much, you know, technical stuff. My apartment now looks like some type of recording studio, a television studio, which is great so that we can share this with you. Today, we're lucky enough that we can all be together. Everyone here has been vaccinated. Whoever comes into my house, that's the story. And singers can sing again. But there's still the issue that can they rehearse with people? And this is still a problem because pianos are not always available. Schools are very particular about who they let in and who can actually come in on the premises to work. So I chose these four singers, or they wanted to perform. I asked them and they said yes. And we've each had one rehearsal just to make sure that we're not showing you the really rough, rough product, because that's not fair to them as an artist. But to choose music that they're learning, they're working on, they want to perform. And that today I'm going to try to work with them and to show you what they have to do, especially what they've had to do in the past year with studying a score. It's been very different because they need to really know a whole lot more about what's going on in the piano part. Not that they didn't know before, but now it's even more important because rehearsal time is very, very short. Time on stage is limited in most halls to 90 minutes at a time. So that's what we're going to work on today for the most part. Just trying to, how much can you know and be prepared before you go into these rehearsals? This is very different than opera. With opera, there's always someone giving you this, hopefully, if they know what they're doing, so that you're not necessarily counting all the time and you know when to come in. With song literature, the singers are telling stories, and it's their job to engage with you through all these different languages. And the pianist is there to be inside that story with them as they tell it. And that does not happen with these pre-recorded accompaniments, as I've heard about for the past 16 months. That right there, I think there's a lawsuit that should happen soon, but I'm going to be quiet on that one today. So, without any more of my talking, we're going to get busy, and we welcome our very first singer.
Good afternoon. My name is Sophia Hunt, and I will be singing Widmung by Schumann. Oh,
So I'll let Sophia get herself around here so we can talk. This is the first time you've ever sung this, right? For any people, except for an hour ago.
Yeah.
So something new. Have you sung a lot of Schumann?
Frauenliebe, a lot, but other than that, no.
Okay. Does this have anything to do with that?
Bits of it, yeah. And I think some of the feeling in it is the same.
Mm-hmm. I want to see if we can find a way to erase all the bar lines.
Okay.
This landing is a mathematical thing. Right. It's part of the equation of creating music. And when we let everybody know, this is the downbeat yet again, not unless it's really, really, really important. Mm-hmm. If we can find a way just to tell the story, to say the poem without all this, yes, it's there. But especially in Schumann, there are times when you need to move.
Yeah.
And then if you take time, like after Schwebe, you needed time, it's perfect that you take it, but you need to come back in and move. You can't come back in that same tempo. You have to find a way to make up what you've stolen mm-hmm. with the rubato. This piece is interesting to me because it's always going to the second beat. If we're counting in 3-2, dum ba dum da di da da dum, right? It's not dum da da, but du meine Seele, du mein Herz, du meine Wonne, du mein Schmerz. It's always in the middle. Mm-hmm. When he says, du meine Welt, there's an accent on du. How are you going to make that work without it sounding aggressive? Because I don't get a difference yet.
Okay.
You have to find a way in your, du meine Seele, du mein Herz, du meine Wonne, oh, du mein Schmerz. That has to be different. Mm-hmm. And yours is, it's very well delivered, but it's too broad. This is a chance for you to have something that's more personal. It can still be a big, I mean, it is. It's open.
Yeah.
Definitely. It's a big open canvas in that sense. It's not precious, but there still needs to be this variety when we go from the color changes.
Schmerz. Then the Duke comes back and is like, that can't last too long.
Yes, I said Schmerz, but it's not a bad Schmerz in the sense right. of I hate you. It's, we suffered, right? It was hard. But the Duke. But I don't want to be interested in your singing, mm-hmm. and I don't want anybody out there to be interested in your singing. You know what I mean by that? You've worked with me before. So then the da rein ich schwebe, oh du mein Grab. In das hin hab ich ewig meinen Kummer gab. You've got to finish. And what's the punctuation? Don't look, what's the punctuation at the end of gab?
Exclamation point.
Does that mean anything different? Because you gave away what was coming.
Okay, yeah. With the change in time.
Exactly. Yeah. You can't give that away. I can do that with a guitar. A moment where you need to join, mm-hmm. not to start. As if you're talking, you're talking, you're talking, and you took 2 seconds and you went and you started talking over there because it's more interior. Mm-hmm. You understand? But if du bist die Ruhe, then it sits.
Yeah.
You want to find a way to keep telling that you haven't changed from inside. It's only the outside that all of a sudden it's gone to a very inside, a personal moment, but the energy's still traveling and it's low. Don't let it get heavy mm-hmm. in the sense of emotion.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's try the beginning. Think of going to 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Exaggerate it one time and find out where the schwung is, because there is schwung in this. It's got to swing to that second beat. Okay.
Oh.
I like it more, but I still want to know from you that there's a difference to say, du meine Seele, du mein Herz. I don't get a change in that line.
Okay.
Because it's du meine Seele, du mein Herz. And then it's yours, it's mine. Mm-hmm. There is a possessive thing to it, but it's something that brings you joy.
Yeah.
You're not afraid of it. And when you come back in, du meine Vaughn, how joyful can you sing it instead of, we got to put the spear down for a second.
Okay.
Because it will do my love, Vaughn. No, do my love, let it bloom. It doesn't necessarily have to land huge and then try to go somewhere because you can't get down then.
Right.
It makes it very hard to come off of that. Can you try this for me one time? Just go with me. Everybody, this song is written in this funny middle part of the voice, constantly, and it's hard to sound bright in A flat, though it is possible, but I think he's trying to tell you, because Schumann could have easily chosen A major, easily, because it'd be nicer for the ladies.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not unless you're a mezzo-soprano or somewhere in between. You know, the song was a piece of cake for Jessye. She loved to sing this song constantly as an encore, and it fit. But then you find a soprano voice, a real soprano for you. Ooh, it's much easier when it turns over and the brilliance goes into the room and we can feel that resonance. Mm-hmm. Can you try now? In that, we'll go back to this key and see if you can.
Yeah.
I know it's hard. You know, it's like I'm gonna play on an oboe, then I'm gonna play on a clarinet and try to achieve the same thing. or a flute, it's not gonna happen. But you have to imagine it so that it doesn't get on the low side of things. Okay?
Yeah.
Let's try. You have to have a thought.
Okay.
You're singing. You're going to but there's no thought.
Okay.
You've got to have a thought. Du meine Seele, du mein Herz. You see?
Mm-hmm.
The tiny, it's a split second from you.
Du meine Seele, du mein Herz. Du meine Wange, du mein Schmerz. Du meine Welt, in der ich
phrase.
Yeah.
What is going on here? I love du bist die Ruhe, du bist der Frieden. Who's watching the time for me? I'm sorry. I'm thinking of so many things at one time.
2:22.
Can someone tell me when it's 2:30, please, or 2:28, something like that? We started a few minutes late. After du bist der Frieden, what changes?
It's like this connection to heaven, right? You're being given to me.
Right. Is there anything different in the phrase? So we've had. It's longer. Why does he put that turn in there? To get on your nerves?
It's on me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what do you feel? What's the emotion behind it?
Yeah.
What is it?
Lucky.
Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel? How does it, I get lucky. How does it make you feel inside as a human being in that moment? Where is your breath?
Hi.
Okay. But that's the idea we make them feel, right? But you don't let
but
it come
like
high.
It's like a breathless thing.
Right.
Yeah.
But I get don't articulate it. Sing lyrically, sing through it. If you need time there, then you need to move the first part of your phrase. Mm. Because you could make that in one breath. The du bist vom Himmel mir beschieden. Then you're ready to make the change.
Das
du mich liebst. Be careful that it doesn't. You got to get into your voice down here.
Okay.
It all of a sudden becomes this kind of a breathy, consonanty thing that's going on. You want to make sure that you keep singing. Das du mich liebst. Das, yes, it's short, but it's not short enough that we can't hear you or feel that you actually have a sound down there. Can we go back to Du bist die Ruhe, please? Let me try to play the bar before, and you try to join where you think it's going to land.
Okay.
Okay? You're early or late?
I was late,
The retard is in the bar. The bar before, so 1, 2, want anybody to know, you want them to have their, because that's what you feel like.
Right.
Inside though, you're standing completely still, like, wow, this is happening to me.
Right.
Not bad. Okay, same thing. I'll play the bar before and you join me exactly where you think it's going to
augmenter le son.
J'ai augmenté le volume.
Et où? Merci Siri.
Can do to a singer when they're on a long sustained note is to go slower because nobody likes to feel like they're hung out to dry.
Right.
This entire section is me moving through, but you're not going with me.
Okay, on the not
me. Even from du bist, du bist, you're being very faithful, but it's du bist, du bist. We're going to the second beat, emotionally.
Yeah.
The sound doesn't have to have some huge swell in it, but you have to know that I'm always going. So then when do, listen to that harmony there.
Yeah.
That turn, it comes early. You're waiting me. Keep going.
Okay.
Direct the line. You're allowed to. Because you love me, I find my own worth.
Right.
It's a little dependent,
but
it's 19th century and we're going to go with it. But it's an amazing thing to be able to say, das du mich liebst, macht mich mir wert. Dein Blick hat mich vor mir verklärt. Whoa.
Right.
It's constantly the dein, mir, da, this thing, the symbiosis, and that's why everything has to change.
But you gotta get Bescheiden.
Right.
Rubato is that to steal, but you have to give it back.
Yeah.
And every time you have a long note, I move. Das du mich liebst. And then I give you time. Mach mich liebst. Dein Blick hat Heil.
You have to struggle to say those three words.
Yeah.
Du hebst mich liebend. If it doesn't kill you, then it's not right. It's got to be that amazing for you, for him to slip that harmony in here and do this. There's no time.
Yeah.
Time is gone. And you have, you're also in charge then, how do I get us back into time? And you gave it away when you said, mein guter Geist. You can't get, you can't telegraph that we're going back to sing the beginning again.
Oh, okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
Du hebst mich liebend über mich, mein guter Geist, mein bestes Ich. Du meine Seele. Then it flies.
Yeah.
Then you ride the wave. But you have to create it. That's what's hard. But all of the dee 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 thing, dee 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 dee. You have to know how you want to tell a pianist how to phrase those things. Not the easiest thing to do, but gotta do it. Das du mich liebst, thank you. We're 2:30? Okay.
Das du mich liebst.
Das du.
Das du.
Don't put the S and the D all together.
Das du.
Make sure the D of du is clear.
Okay. Das du mich liebst, macht mich mir weh.
Tiny, tiny little things of every sound that comes from you, it can't just be made.
Right.
You have to have something from deep within you to understand why is the minor, meine Welt, in dir ich lebe, mein Himmel du. You can say, mein Himmel du. No.
Right.
It's on the stage. You've got to let it go. Let's try one more time from the reprise of Du meine Seele. I'll play the bar before. First time, that's great.
Thank you.
But you need to practice it up the half step.
Right, and get that.
Just to remind yourself that, oh wow, my voice can leave that easily.
Right.
Because when you go a half step down, you start, you lean on it just enough to where it drags.
Yeah.
And then you start losing the middle of your voice. Because that B flat, this is a study in B flat.
Mm-hmm.
It's just over and over and over again. It's like, okay.
Yeah.
So just pay attention to that. But the middle section, say it to the room over and over and over and over again to where it feels natural for you, because there's a lot of going on in there, a lot. And if you don't feel fluent, you're just going to revert to singing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not fun.
Right.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And our next contestant.
And I have to apologize, the program says die Nacht instead of die Nachtigall, so I thought I caught that, and somehow it's not there.
One of the easiest songs to jump up and sing. Ha ha. But she chose it, so there. But you can sing it, right?
Yes.
Now you got that clear in your head?
Yeah.
You believe it now?
Yes.
It can happen. So, this period of music, this expressionism, this, he's a baby, he's a young man writing this.
Yeah.
So this pulling and pushing and all that stuff. You're very good at slowing it down, but then when it's time to, you have to move, it's not quite clear. You're just like, okay, I gotta go faster here.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
You have to have a reason why, because if you don't, then your voice doesn't go into where it needs to, so it can resonate.
Okay.
It loses sound. And all these, we talked about this before. Da-dee-da-da-da.
Yeah.
What does Zusen mean?
Sweet.
Exactly. You get to it, I'm sure Zieglinda would be envious of you, because if you don't have to go big. You all of a sudden are in the top of your voice, so it's going to be heard.
True. Okay.
If you found a way to land there, to land, just physically think the physics of jumping and landing on something that you're not going for this, and you land for Zeus. If you can do that, then you can make the crescendo that he marks. You see that? He marks the crescendo.
Yeah.
That for me tells me I need to start less.
Okay.
on the note so that I have somewhere to go. But then when you get down from there, Zusenschal, you haven't sung Schal yet because you're singing Schal because there's so much pressure after Zusenschal.
Okay.
It can't get into the room. It goes backwards on you.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
Keep it flexible.
Okay.
Keep always, you, especially the next. Da sind in Hall und wieder. If you hit big, you have nowhere to go. Keep it flexible. Sing a little bit less volume, but mean it even more from your spirit.
Okay.
You know,
sure.
I understand this is ridiculously hard. I get it. And that you get to sing it, do it twice, like Sophia's piece. If you don't get it the first time, oh, wait, we get to try it again. Let me see if I can get it this time. Which is, you know, it just plays with our brains. We're all, it's like Mozart concerto, Mozart sonata, same thing. The recapitulation comes back, and we're all like, oh gosh, I messed up the first time. I hope I get it right the second time. The beginning, das macht. Say that for me into the room with that energy.
Das macht.
Don't use your larynx to move the pitch. Use your emotion. Use your das macht.
Das macht.
I hear da, da. You hear what I'm doing?
Da.
I'm pushing it down. Das macht.
Das macht.
Uh-huh. I'm already on the high note on the first note.
Ah.
I'm not digging down and then trying to crawl my way out.
Okay.
Das macht.
Das macht.
Right.
Oh, I still kind of see it though.
You feel it?
Yeah.
Because you said da, da, da,
da,
da,
da.
Right. They do it the way the Italians would do it.
Da.
Da. Right, but they sing.
Yeah.
Das macht.
Das macht.
Right. Sing that, please.
Das macht. Das macht.
Da, 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 da,
da, da.
No draw.
Da.
Da 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 da
da
da da
da da da da
da da
da da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da. You're waiting until it's time to come in, da, and you trip on the D. That's why that portamento is hard for you.
Yeah. Okay.
But if you find where you can get into your sound, then you'll go up the hill without a problem.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Let's try. Did it feel sad to you?
Yeah.
Okay. At least, okay, it wasn't a trick question. I'm glad I got that part.
Well, I was just like, no.
Es hat die Nachtigall. Say that for me.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
With no jaw.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
Exactly. Your tongue is on break. You're sleeping in there. Es hat die Nachtigall. Es hat die Nachtigall.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
Because I wanted to go that way. I don't want to go, es hat die Nachtigall. Right.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
Right there.
Es hat die Nachtigall.
There you go. You hear a difference on the top. Your top note settles versus all of a sudden you arriving going, oh God, this is really big. How did we get there? You know, keep it simple. Tell the story the way you would tell it. But because it's singing, we start using all sorts of other equipment that we don't need. One more time.
Es hat die Nachtigall,
die ganze Nacht.
Die ganze Nacht gesungen.
Good. What does etwas zögernd mean?
With more time.
What does etwas mean? Somewhat. Not mucho. Not boku. Not sehr. But etwas.
Okay.
It's like, you know, consider it while you're traveling. Because,
okay.
I mean, come on, he's young.
Yeah.
He's not trying to get you to run out of breath, but he got to like, oh God, that's hard. Why is that phrase so hard? It shouldn't be hard. Because then, das in von ihren, that's hard when all this stuff starts moving.
Yeah.
Okay. Die ganze Nacht. Die ganze. Say it for me that way one time.
Die ganze.
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 Right.
Your breath. Sorry. I'm just like a little sheep. Okay.
Die ganze Nacht.
Ganze. I'm a long time on that G sharp.
Oh.
Die ganze. Da sind von, sind von. Sing that for me. Sind von.
Sind von.
Sind von.
Sind von.
Sind. Sind.
Sind von.
Right. Z, I, N, and T are on the same line. Sind von.
Sind von.
That's why you run out of breath.
Sind von.
Sind
von.
Thank you.
Okay.
It's like with das du mich. Same das du. You lose all your air pressure. Here is where you got to make sure you're in control.
Yeah.
Da sind von ihrem. All the buzzing noises you can make in the world. That'll keep your mouth from doing that.
Okay. Da sind von ihrem süßen Schaum.
Good, good. Do a subito pianissimo on süßen this time. Sing forte all the way until süßen.
Da sind von ihrem süßen Schaum. Da sind im Hall und...
In Hall, that's right, we figured that out.
Vowel is happening in a place that has no responsibility for a vowel. How's that?
Okay.
The workers ran upstairs and tried to take over the president's office of the company. You're the president. Be in charge. Your brain knows it's O. We cannot sing roll up on that note.
Okay.
Keep your throat open, whatever makes you keep your throat open, then you'll get the sound. You got to stay with that. You want to do something to the note when you're on it. Do you need to? If you just sing beautifully just all the way through and say, see it, keep seeing the blah, and once you push, you're not going to get to the G.
Okay.
Keep concentrating your way through it. This is one of those moments, if you can't concentrate, you're truly in trouble.
Okay.
D. Listening to you, so you understand the difference there.
A little bit. I think I'm still Z. That's all the air versus Z.
Z. Z. Z. Z. Is something we have to practice because a lot of people Z Z Z Z when people speak, and you might have your speech pattern could be there. If you're from Balmer, let me tell you, you have all sorts of interesting issues with consonants and vowels too, but it's based on a consonant. Zivar. Zivar doch sonst ein wildes. All those sounds. Let's just take this note right here. Sing the whole phrase on that note. Zivar.
Okay.
Zivar doch sonst ein wildes Blut.
There's a lot of stuff going on with those
Z's. Yeah.
You feel it? Did you guys hear
it? No, I do. No, I
this okay. Should be like you're speaking. When you intone on one note, you can still use your voice, but Zivar doch sonst. We don't want any of that.
Right.
You hear all that loose?
Yeah.
You lost it.
Yeah.
You spend everything.
Sonst ein wildes Blut.
There you go.
Sonst ein.
Oh, it's
clean. Yeah, it's clean.
Sonst ein.
You're treating consonants as something that impede your progress. They stop your line. You want them to keep going.
Yeah.
Especially in this piece, in this style. It's all just, it's over the top. But that's what makes it so extraordinary, that someone can actually throw it out there that way, emotionally, and even if they're terrified. You know, this thing has happened. This bird is singing. This makes me feel this way, but I wasn't like this before. What's happened? That's what you want to feel.
Doch sonst.
Say that.
Doch sonst.
Doch.
Doch.
Sonst.
Sonst.
Doch.
Doch.
Sonst. Doch.
Doch.
Sonst.
Sonst.
So from TCH, you have to understand, you have to get back to where that Z is. But if your CH okay. goes down here,
yeah.
Where is Z going to be? Which brings us into, oh, she's singing. We don't want to know about that.
Okay.
Okay? Doch sonst?
With the Z?
Just doch sonst.
Doch
so.
Oh. Doch sonst.
Sing doch by itself.
Doch sonst.
But don't he lie.
Doch sonst.
Is what the word is. But doch, then we get CH and Z all mixed up together between two notes. And all that does is make your voice go this way. People are out there. You need your voice to go that way. One more time, doch sonst.
Doch sonst.
Right, it's a very quick tongue action that you have to practice because it's not native.
This isn't your first language. You know, and you have to practice that stuff. Nun geht sie tief in Sinnen.
Nun geht.
Don't shadow schwa.
Nun geht.
Right, you can sing the end. Nun.
Nun geht sie tief in Sinnen.
Thank you. You guys hear the difference in the room? It's perfectly clear. Now this next little phrase, when she's whispering, when she's a little sad. Right. Still, you scared everybody. And it's the opposite of is the opposite, but it's the opposite of what still means.
Trägt ihn.
Finish trägt and then sing ihn.
Trägt ihn. In der Hand den Sommerhut und duldet still.
Finish Uh-huh. The sh belongs to still. It doesn't belong to duldet.
You're right.
That?
Duldet still der Sonne Glut und weiß
und?
Und weiß nicht
und?
Was
und?
Und weiß nicht was beginnt.
Hallelujah.
Okay.
You feel the difference out there?
Yeah.
It's so beautiful. So beautiful. And it's all yours. That's the best part. How much time do I have? 5 minutes. Oh, good. We're going to go. Now, this is something to think about. You guys, come on, look at this. You all have the score in front of you. Can you see it? So that thing is all pretty simple and straightforward. The piano's just kind of doing a little offbeat thing. And then she finishes when we get to Weiß nicht was beginnen. And you look at the next measure, and she said, that Hannah said the other day, goes, that 4-4 bar. Well, you know, when you sing this with an orchestra, the conductor, you hope he has your back and he lets you know when to come in. But there's also an accelerando. But if you know what to listen for, advice. Look at the piano part, there's an E natural. And then E flat, D, C sharp. She's being pulled back and forth. The C sharp and the C natural do that to her. Of what you're supposed to be on.
Yeah.
You guys get one note at a time. It's not like my story over here where I have to sometimes play 10 notes at a time. You get one note at a time, which means you really have to do your very best to make sure you can get into that note. There are all these things you have to deal with. I understand all that. The registration and blah, blah, all these languages. Yes. But das macht es hat die Nacht. That I know where every note is on its, what word I'm singing. But when I start blending it all together, there is no, that's not legato at all. Because it kills your line. And then your voice spreads. That, when you sang da sind von ihr, if you vocalize that, sing that on this note, da sind von ihr.
Da sind von ihr.
That, all that explosion is not going to help you.
Da sind von ihrem süßen Schall.
Right. You feel the difference?
Yeah.
You don't have to explode it. It's like, oh, could you give us an F? Here's $500. They asked for five. It doesn't mean it's more out there. It actually means it's less. Because it doesn't have, there's no more focus for it to travel. Does it?
Da sind von ihrem süßen.
You're taking your larynx to find the note.
Da, z,
da, z,
da, z,
right. Da, sind.
Da, sind von ihr.
Sind.
Sind.
And you got to sing the end. Support.
Sind.
Right. Then we hear everything. Because there's beauty in your consonants. If you guys bank only on vowels, oh dear God. There are many more consonants, unfortunately. But you make those beautiful by the way you say things, and you get to say it twice. Da sind von ihrem süßen Schall. Schal. Practice that. Then you go, don't sing shawl when you get there because you run out of breath.
Schal.
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 Da sind in Hall und wieder Hall. Da sind und Hall und wieder Hall. I'm exaggerating big time.
Well.
But it's blah, 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 blah. That's the emotion of this stuff. And you feel what your top voice does. The A is like, ooh, okay. Not an issue at all. And it's beautiful. Truly beautiful. And it's yours. Doesn't sound like anybody else. Do you have any questions? Anybody out there have any questions? Anybody in Radio Land have any questions? Blair, I don't know if you're there. People are writing in. If they do, they have scores and they want to ask something. Better now than later.
Yes, I've provided them with the score. So if there are any questions, please feel free to drop it in the chat.
Thank you. So you're cool?
Thank you.
And we can work on that some more, but really, yeah. Beautiful. Thank you. All right, now we're going to switch languages.
Hello, my name is Anastasia Sidorova, and I will be singing Soupir by Duparc.
Is this the first time you performed this, performed it with a piano, a live piano?
Yeah.
So, who is this? Who is this dedicated to?
I mean, Duparc meant it for his mother.
Right.
And this song is about the person who's not there anymore.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that is his mother?
I don't know. Not necessarily.
Right.
Yeah.
Who? Why do you think he would dedicate it to her? Do we know? Because I looked and looked and I couldn't find anything.
Yeah, me neither.
I couldn't find anything specific. To see, never to see or hear her. And it's very clear that she always loved me and now she's gone.
Right.
Which is very simple.
Yeah.
And straightforward. It's not some complex.
No.
There might be some complex feelings behind it all, but the surface of it, I should say, is very straightforward. Do you know the original key of this song?
Do you mind?
Mm-hmm. And do you know where that sits? High.
Much higher.
So, I think, you know, of course, everybody doesn't sing things in the same key. But if you don't go back and look at the original to understand what he's done,
the colors, yeah.
The color. And what a soprano, if a soprano sings this. Where's your first note?
Oh my God. Much higher.
Right?
Yeah.
We don't want it to sound like his mother singing.
Yeah.
You know? And your transposition went down a fourth.
Yeah.
Which is a long way. And it's not that I want you to sing higher, but it's this suspended thing for a soprano to sing. Those are E's down to a D, and then the next phrase is a G, which for a soprano, they'll be looking at you going, because it's gotta be floating.
Yeah.
It's this detached. We have to find that for your voice.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to sing in this key, but I have this key, which is an old French volume where they printed things in middle keys. Have you seen it?
Yeah.
No, you're in the basement key.
Oh, yeah.
I have a key in between all those, and we're gonna try it and see how this works. Other key because no one needs to sing in that key because it's not going to be high enough for anybody. It's not a matter of being high to where you're uncomfortable, but it's got to be at a certain place where you can't say ne jam, where you can dig in.
Yeah,
because you like to dig in, and I get that, but in this piece there's no such thing as that, so it's got to sit high enough to remind you no
yeah.
Digging. Could you dispose of this, please? No, when I saw that, I said, please send me your score. And I looked and went, oh my God, what key is this? I mean, I played the last note on the piano at the end. It really kind of a little strange when I see that. At least I got to play all the notes. But, can you sing on this note for me? No before it. That your throat is open and everything is in position to sing.
Yeah.
No. You feel that? The reach. Right. Now do it in this register. those are the same vowels.
Yeah.
La, do you sing la? No, um sound.
La.
La ta. You sing la. La ta.
La tendre.
I hear an N.
La.
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 Like the word law in English. L-A-W. La ta.
La tendre.
Uh huh. That's plenty. Can you do it without your jaw?
La tendre.
Thank you. We get your tongue to work. Then you and Hannah can have a little session. What's your first word?
Ne.
Ne. Uh-huh. How do you make that vowel? What's it based on?
Ne. E. O.
No. E. Good. Sing A to E to the schwa on this note. Right there. It's all piano, remember. Find a reason to sing piano. But open your throat. You want to close it down to be precious. You understand what I mean by
yeah,
that?
Yeah.
It's too fragile. Same thing. Go ahead. Open E. You sang oh, oh, ne pouvoir. Ah, say ah for me.
Ah.
Ah, let go of your tongue, let go of your larynx, let go of everything and see what comes out. Ah.
Ah.
Thank you. We don't need to draw. Ah. Ah.
Ah.
Good. There we go. There's your sound. Più forte come from what?
Feeling.
No, from what was the dynamic previous?
Oh, sorry. diminuendo.
No.
And
piano.
Oh yeah, piano.
Piano. So it's più forte. It's a little bit louder than piano.
Yeah.
Not forte. Mm-hmm. Don't show them everything you have. Ever. Toujours le même.
Thank you.
new key.
Oh, I love it. Love it.
Is it better out there? I want you to really think about how, same thing with Hannah, that you anticipate consonants and kill your voice, because you have this glorious sound that comes out. But when you sing that phrase for me, because it's still not peaceful for you yet. Think the vowels. Don't try to, you don't have to worry about singing. Lord knows you don't have to worry about singing. You sing just fine. Trust it that the ah will come out. Right. You hear the difference? It's much more vulnerable, but that way we actually listen. The other is so much coming at us that we don't know, we don't know what to pay attention to. But then we really don't pay attention and we disengage. You need to offer the bare necessity of what it means and make us lean towards you. That's the loudest moment in the whole song.
Yeah.
And it's not even that loud. I mean, you're gonna have to practice it thinking that this is his mother.
Yeah.
And that he is saying these words. And then he has to, yet again, we have a third song here where it comes back to the beginning. And this recapitulation where you have to sing that line, this whole page again. What, why? What was all that torment in the middle where it's hard to know when to come in? You know? Come on, and this song that's been so simple. Look at the introduction. How many voices do we have going on at the same time? You've got the top line. We'll call those the violins or flute, okay? You have this thing up here. Da-dum, da-dum, dum. Then beneath that we have, right? And then the tenor part. Da-dum. The tenors always have to be heard. Da-dum, da-dum. And then the bass. Anchoring. So I have to find a way in my imagination, why are we? You hear on the third beat every time there's this horrible dissonance. So you decide, what sound do I really need? You have all this amazing voice. There's no need to spend it all on this song.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
So you now played it in three different keys. So is it, how is it different for the pianist to play it in the different keys?
When you're up here, there's something that's more haunting, more ghost-like, that I don't have all this down here that makes it sound anchored, so that it floats. But at the same time, you have a singer who's trying to sing in the very top of their voice quietly. Some days that works, some days it doesn't.
For you as a pianist.
Right, but it changes when someone sings because I still have to support them. And that's the scary part in the song, because somebody comes in and they're nervous and they're like, no, I'm to get to a G, and they don't sing the G quietly, I have to play more. This for me is a more comfortable because it still floats.
Yeah.
this is, that always drives me crazy to play in the soprano key. This key I like. Right, and I'm happy that I found it. Do you need a copy of it? Please take it and burn the other one. Oh, please, please. Do you have any questions?
No.
You guys hear the difference?
Yes.
Because it's so beautiful. Thank you.
Mark, can you hear me from here? I'm not sure.
Right.
No? Okay.
All right. What time do we have? Where are we? Oh, good. Hi, Patrick. How are you?
I'm good. My name is Patrick Wilhelm, and I will be singing I Hear an Army by Samuel Barber.
Another easy song.
Welcome, Mark.
So, do you know the other songs of Opus 10?
Yes.
And tell me about it.
They are Sleep Now, and I think that's the first one.
First one is Rain Has Fallen.
And then Sleep Now, and then this one.
Okay. In these lovely volumes which editors make, in which volume are the original keys? One and two are in the original key, which is the middle.
Right.
And the I Hear an Army in the original key is, they call it the high key, whatever, it's the original key.
C minor, yeah.
Right, it's in C minor. For me, I have to think about that.
Yep.
Color-wise, because when we're down a third in the piano, which all of a sudden, blah, 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 all this noise that goes on. There's a lot happening. I hope you could hear him the whole time. Good. But at the same time, I think you're having to oversing. And when it's quiet, I know you have that in you. And I want to hear this arrogant in black armor.
Yeah.
That it's And this is a nightmare.
Yeah.
It is truly a scene that you can't wake up from. You're fighting, and then by the end, it's Game of Thrones. It's just insanity. You know, arrogant in black armor. Behind them stand, disdaining the reins with fluttering whips.
Yeah.
You've got to find a way to pace it to where it doesn't sound like you're just on the gas.
Right.
The moment when you got a little flustered with your words, I moan in sleep when I hear it's all
yeah,
of a sudden piano. That is hard.
Yeah.
And if you've extended too far in the big direction prior to that, it is really hard to get back to quiet.
True.
You have to think about that. My job is to be underneath you in the sound of that you're making and not more than you're making and balance it. Because the piano part is monstrous, you know, but it's a lot of rhythm, and rhythm doesn't have to be loud.
Mm-hmm.
It just needs to be rhythmic underneath you. But this, I moan in sleep when I hear afar their whirling laughter. And then even quieter, they cleave the gloom of dreams, a blinding flame, clanging, clanging upon the heart as upon an anvil. They come. It's relentless emotionally, but it cannot be relentless with volume.
Right.
Because then they're not going to listen. They will not appreciate it. It'll get to the end, and if you have to sing this with two other songs in front of it, I promise you it's going to be like, oh, thank God that's over. Because
mm-hmm.
it's a lot. Can we try the beginning?
Yes.
I want you to find out where is forte for you in the storytelling. Right now, I feel that you're letting it rip and letting everybody hear everything you have.
Yeah.
Resonance is great. Volume is another story.
Yeah.
You've got 7 pages to go through. Give yourself the time to pace it. So when you start your story, everyone's not, what?
Yeah, yeah.
It's already, that's already warning enough if this is a mess coming up, people.
Yeah.
Get ready.
Can't even come down on the first beat.
Right, exactly. And be careful that you don't sing hi here in Army.
Yeah.
Because I hear hi.
Okay.
It's cute, hi. But hi here in Army. All right, let's try. Because honestly, none of this is high. None of it. Until you get to the very, very end.
Yeah.
And so if you can sing, this is like what Sophia did. You have to go up, and then when you come back down, you realize, oh, wow, because your first note sounds like you're landing on a downbeat. I hear. That doesn't work. I hear an army charging up on the land.
Yeah.
Then you can do charging up on the land.
Yeah.
And hit those the way he's marked everyone's sostenuto. Okay, let's try.
There we go, thank you. We're gonna unlock it now.
Yep.
And one.
I know Patrick, and I know that he has an extraordinary high voice, and I'm determined to hear it today. Thank you for your patience. Sing that, and the thunder horses. And just sing.
Okay.
You can sing this. I know you can. And?
The notes.
And the thunder of horses plunging foam about their knees.
You have perfect pitch or something?
No, but it's once it's in there, it kind of just stays.
Uh-huh, that sounds like something we need to talk about. Uh-huh. Because you don't want to be locked, because as you guys well know, how many days do you feel exactly the same in your throat?
Never.
2 in a year?
In a year.
Maybe, but they're still 300 days apart?
Yeah.
You know, you cannot rely on this. It's not going to, yeah, you have a great gift. God knows, it's extraordinary. But you don't need to bear down on it to where it's stuck in a place.
Mm-hmm.
You know? This is not high for your voice right here.
No.
But we need to find out a way for you to move around. You might have to sing it in between these keys.
Yeah.
You know? Which means somebody's going to have to transpose, but that's okay.
Yeah.
They'll get over it. From the beginning. One.
Upon the land.
Yeah, boulders. Leave the first. I hear an army charging up on the land.
Yep.
As much variety. One. Voice is too heavy, you can't move.
Yeah.
They cleave.
They cleave our dreams of blinding fire. Clang, clang upon the heart as upon an anvil.
Have you no wisdom? Don't take a breath later.
It's a great idea. I've never done that.
So, look what goes on in the measure you have to come back in for my, which is not easy.
No.
After sure. On my last note,
yeah.
And I'm going to give you all the time in the world
to make it happen.
To do that, and then my heart.
Yeah.
How are you going to make with? He says piano with sudden intensity, as if we haven't had intensity prior to this moment.
Suddenly.
But that means there's something that's unreal about the expression.
Yeah.
There was a period before this when all this they right. come out of the sea and run shouting by the shore. Stop. And then, this is where the poem shifts.
Yeah.
We have no idea. We think this is all about an army and all this crazy people with green hair.
Yeah.
And then my heart, have you no wisdom?
Yeah.
Then we understand where we're going. So it's sure. Playing the piano, and he chose his keys for reasons
yeah.
and for sounds. There are very few baritones who could sing this, mm-hmm. a dramatic tenor, might deal with it, but it's not a soprano. No soprano wants to have a crescendo on a G flat.
Right.
They're like, oh my God, how horrible to be sitting on a G flat to go to a G natural. It's for a medium voice.
Yeah.
And you sang all the notes effortlessly and much slower than you actually did. Your effort
is like nothing.
Exactly. Your effort is your business.
Yeah.
We were not aware of that. I wasn't aware of it. It sounded like it was going to keep going forever. But you have to make your decision. Where you have to say, my love, my love, my love, three times. You're getting stuck on each one, even in the other key.
Yeah. Yeah.
It says very broadly, I've set it up for you. I don't think we need to go any slower than where it ends with this. And then a gasp. Why? That why has got to terrorize the world because
yes.
We still don't understand what it's about.
Yep.
We still don't know. It's why have you left me alone?
Yeah.
And that's what you have to set up for all of us. So, let's go back to the same place at my heart. I'll play the few bars before. Absolutely spectacular. It's the first time I've actually heard somebody sing it when I thought, oh good, the right voice, because the tenor sings this and at the beginning you're going, hi. Or they're yelling.
Right.
And when they go up, trying to make resonance when their voice doesn't have it.
Yeah.
But the whole bloody thing sits right in the middle of your voice until the end.
Yeah.
And if you sing this other stuff well, look how much more nuance you have.
Yeah, it's true.
You are right.
Well, that's not about me being right. It's for you and the music that you feel that you can tell a story better.
Yeah.
And get it to go out of the room. These phrases from Arrogant, In Black Armor. You were trying to sing all that in one breath earlier.
Yeah.
It's a Arrogant, In Black Armor. Behind them stand, disdaining the reins. The stand, disdaining the reins with fluttering whips.
Yeah.
The charioteers. There's nothing normal about this.
No.
And if your diction is normal, it sounds like you might have lost your mind in the wrong way.
Right. Yeah.
They cry unto the night their battle name. I moan in sleep. You have to practice it as if you're some great Shakespearean actor.
Yeah.
I mean, if I walk around my apartment doing it, I know you can do it, okay? I'm sure my neighbors think I'm insane sometimes. Clanging, clanging upon the heart as upon an anvil. Da-bum, and the piano. Whatever that is, the wrong key.
Yeah.
They come shaking in triumph their long green. I don't get that word means anything to you.
Yeah.
Do you have a lot of friends with green hair? Oh God, it's a bad question these days. But you know,
yeah.
That's got to be, you've got to be able to say it in a way that doesn't sound like it's green hair.
Yeah.
You know, there's a sneer in it. There's
yeah.
just, it's disgusting. They come out of the sea and run shouting by the shore. And then what happens?
Yeah.
He's.
Yeah.
He can't talk. And that's why this back and forth.
More, sure.
More.
It's all that.
Uh-huh. But just to simplify, my.
Yeah.
I get what you want.
Yeah, yeah.
But you got to make sure we're not questioning. What was that word?
Right.
Because my heart, have you no wisdom thus to... I mean, really, that's the end. This intensity of, have you no wisdom thus to despair? And you need to be able to crescendo on despair,
mm-hmm.
not fade.
Right.
I'll stay underneath you. But if you hit spare big, then I have no option but to play big. You understand?
Right.
You got to have somewhere to go. That's not a high note there. Smacked up in the middle of your voice.
Right.
How much time do I have?
3:40.
3:40? What have we done?
Nothing.
Oh, everybody has several songs to sing. I can't wait. Find out from Blair if people have questions. I'm happy to talk with people who have questions. I want to do the whole song again.
Okay.
And see, I thought we started at 3:20. Yeah, okay. Gosh, you guys are good. But I might bring somebody back. Get ready.
Your entrance is late. Yeah, I'm going to not look at the wrong pitches. See how that does me. Okay.
But it is. They come out shaking in triumph, their long green hair. Green did not sound green.
Yeah.
Let's go back to they cleave.
Yeah.
They cleave the human dreams of blinding flame. Clanging upon the heart as upon an anvil.
I'm sure you have it.
Oh,
everyone promise me you'll sing in that key?
Yeah.
Good. Because I have spies.
Yes. I know them too.
I have spies. No, because it really, I thought about it and thought about it and thought about it. I said, well, do I push him to do it? I said, I'm not going to say a word about it. I'll be singing the other key. We did a rehearsal in the other key. And I thought, we'll find out. But when you get too low, you start just spending and spending and spending and spending. And then when it gets to the top, there's nothing left.
Yeah.
There's nothing special. This, yeah, it is desperate.
Yeah.
You need to make us think that it might break, but that you know that it's not. Just the way you sang it the very first time. You knew it wasn't going to break.
Yeah.
You knew that. No, but you know it. We all know that. You go up for something, you know if it's going to break or not.
Yeah.
And you were in and you're like, my love, on that nasty E natural.
Yeah.
It's E natural now. You have all this power. Put an A flat on the top. No, it's not very high. It's your voice. Mm-hmm. But see, he has a spectacular high voice. Spectacular. And if you don't show it,
yeah.
You sing the other two songs.
Yes. That's what one of my questions is, like, if I was to program this in a set of things, like, this now takes almost the place of, like, an art. Like, I sing an aria with, an A flat in it. But it's, like, I use that for auditions, and it's, like, in the context of an opera, which makes a little more sense. But if you were going to program, I think probably similarly to, like, Widmung, like, if you're going to program these things, you want to, like, make sure that you're being cautious of, like, I knew that I can sing it in this key.
Right, but it's called sense when you program things that you make sure, especially you guys, it's very different than the rest of us.
Right.
You have an instrument to deal with, and you have to be able to deliver your program every time. But if you pick a program that you can only deliver when you're in your very best form,
right,
and your very best health, and the hall is perfect, and the piano is great, and you like the pianist,
yeah.
How many of those variables come together? I've done this for 40 years, and I can promise you those things are rare.
Yeah.
And that's why you appreciate them when they happen.
Yeah.
But when you choose your program, you know, I would put these three, so you put these three songs at the end of the first half of the program.
Right.
And then have a little break. Because they're all three amazing.
Yeah.
And these incredible atmospheres from such a young composer, Opus 10. You know? But, okay, fine. You don't need to sing everything with high A-flats, but not all songs have high A-flats.
It's true.
But Barber decided this song needed it for it to work.
Yeah.
And the rest of the piece, you wouldn't know what key it was in, whether it was high key, low key, whatever. It all sits perfectly for your voice, mm-hmm. and you actually carry much better over all this cacophony that's going on. No matter how well I balance it, there's still a lot going on.
Yes.
And that your voice must be on the top of that, but once you drop down and you're here and this is, you can't control the noise down there sometimes.
Right.
It just keeps ringing.
Yeah.
You know, it lasts longer.
Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
No.
Will you also promise me that you will practice saying the text and not sing the text? All of you. If you can't say it and find your who you are, then don't try to sing it. Because you're just using your talent of singing to cover up what you don't know. I know it's terrifying. You all have these amazing instruments which kind of just do their thing. I know you work very hard, okay? But you have something special in here that the average person does not have. But if you want people to connect to this music, then you have to be willing to put that aside and tell this. Yeah, you happen to be driving through town in your Rolls Royce. Fine. Drive nicely like everybody else. Don't try to show off. But this is what Barber, he knew what voices could do. Look who he wrote for.
Yeah.
Between Stieber and Leontine Price and even himself, he knew what voices were capable of.
Right.
This is not a high voice piece.
Yeah.
It has a couple high notes. And if you've sung the rest of it, well, your G and A flat are pretty much guaranteed. And they're going to force you to sing the rest of it the best you can sing.
Right.
Because the other way it was getting a little lazy.
Yeah, you are right.
I'm right. Just that you understand and can feel, wow, I can spend a whole lot less and get a whole lot more in the room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the game, is what are you going to put in the room?
Right.
At the best price. But if you make yourself tired with one song, why would you? How could you stand up and sing the next group? I'd be terrified. You know, I've been on stage before with someone got allergies to something that blew in. and the voice just disappeared. Disappeared while I was playing. And we got off the stage and I had lost my voice too. Because it was an insecticide that blew in. Mm-hmm. And my, oh, I was talking like this. And imagine the poor singer. So, do we have any questions? Ladies, my three ladies on the couch. Patrick, thank you. Thank you for being such a good sport. Any questions, ladies? Do we have questions over here?
Hello. Can I be, I'm not sure if I, you can hear me. Good. Excellent. Well, thank you today, Mark. That was brilliant. And the singers, Sophia, Hannah, Anastasia, and Patrick, you were all wonderful. Very, very talented. And the work was truly excellent. Superb. We did have a wonderful comment from Alonso Lopez, Alonso Jordan Lopez, who said that the higher key on this last song that Patrick sang was just wonderful. So much, he loved hearing it in the higher key. So I think that was a brilliant choice really on your part with all the singers when you played around with the keys, revealing new colors. So I did want to also add just one little anecdotal piece of information maybe that would be interesting for Anastasia, who sang the Duparc. Because I happen to have read his personal diaries and I know why this was dedicated to his mother. Just might be a little point of interest, the year before when he met his wife, an Irish woman, Ellie McSweeney, their relationship was not well received. And so in the beginning, he had to win over her brother. So his first song, Chanson Triste, is dedicated to her brother. Then he went to dedicate this next song to Ellie, Soupir. But unfortunately, his father was against their relationship and refused to let them marry. So the mother intervened and she probably told him she would leave him, who knows what. But after pretty much taking the father to task, the father relented and decided to let them marry. So he was so, Duparc was so relieved that he could marry that he changed the dedication from his fiance, Ellie McSweeney, to his mother, to show his gratitude. So that's why. And then the next year in 1870, L'Invitation en Voyage came out and he dedicated that to his wife, so.
Blair, this is why you are in charge.
Anyway, I thought it was interesting. So it was, again, you sang it beautifully and the work that you did with Mark was just superb. Any questions out there in our virtual world? I do hear someone coming in. One second.
Oui, 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 oui. Moi, je veux dire quelque chose en français à Marc.
Ah, sûr. Absolument.
Parce que Marc parle français comme moi, qui oui. suis française. Uh-huh. Et je veux lui dire un immense merci pour son talent extraordinaire que j'aime beaucoup. I'm so sorry you don't understand my French, but I'm just saying to Marc how much I love to follow him all over the world.
Merci.
Thank you so much for that. Merci infiniment. That was beautiful. Any other questions in any language? French, German, Italian. Mark can handle them all. So if any other questions or comments? Mark, I do have a quick question about Widmung. Since you did the wonderful work today with Sophia, and you play the piano transcription of that, and I was just wondering how that is for you when you're playing it. Do the piano version, you know, are you hearing the singer's voice? Are you hearing the poetry?
No, I'm hearing my voice and the poetry.
Okay.
Since we don't need to hear my voice, it's my voice in my head.
Right.
And how these words, you know, it causes us to phrase, really know the words, then you play differently. And it's very obvious when a pianist goes after that piece and doesn't know the text. Liszt then decided he was going to amplify it even more and make it bigger. It makes you do it again at the end with all this pyrotechnical stuff at the piano, but it is still Widmung of Schumann. And those words are still there. The words don't go away.
Well, I invite you all to check out, if you can, Mark, he was kind enough to add that piece to a recital he did for us back in February for Valentine's Day, and it was just brilliant. It's so breathtaking to listen to the transcription. Mark, do you want to talk a little bit about your program, Singing in Sicily?
Singing in Sicily, my goodness, it feels like it's sunk into the sea someplace because of this pandemic. In 2017, I started a nonprofit where I could invite four young singers from around the world to participate in 10 days of very intense study and work on arias and operas and, or, you know, and art song, things like that. But it's every day. What we did today was just a tiny, this is what we do every day. You have a class like this that goes on for 2 hours. And then you have a private lesson for an hour every day. And it's a little grueling, but at the same time, I mean, Patrick's been there. He did it. Sophia was to have gone last year. Hopefully we'll all figure this out for this year. We'll talk about that later. But since we couldn't go last summer to Sicily, I did a little bit of private stuff and wanted to go somewhere in Massachusetts in August, but we couldn't because it was just getting more complicated with the virus. And this year I have decided that I'm going to do it right here in my living room in Baltimore. It's not Sicily looking out at the sea, but we can always walk down to the harbor and pretend if that's what we need. So I am going to do it this summer. And I am inviting the four singers you heard today, some of them don't know that yet, to join us. And we're gonna all talk and meet after this to find out what the dates could be so that we can get everybody together, because right now when things are starting to kick into gear, everybody's trying to do everything. And I understand that, but at the same time, everybody needs to get back to doing their work as a group with other people, not just sitting in your practice room plunking out notes.
Yeah.
Because it's too frustrating after 16, 17 months of this. They need to start making music again like we did today. This is such a thrill to be able to hear people and to feel it and to feel what the resonance is and what it can be. And this is what will make a difference in the future. If we invest now, and when we get up on the stage the next time, the public will feel a difference. Not because they haven't heard it in a while, but also because we're in better shape. And that is our job. So that's what Singing in Sicily is. You're interested in supporting, it's a 501c foundation, nonprofit, and people from all over the world give to it, and people all over the world come to it. But like I said, this year, it'll be singing in Baltimore, but we can make music. So thank you, Blair, for asking.
Absolutely. Singing in Sicily by way of Baltimore. So that's what it'll be this year. We've had to be nothing but nimble, as everyone knows. So please, I invite you to check out information about Singing in Sicily and giving to that wonderful program. And obviously, I would be remiss if I didn't also add, if you would like to make a donation today to the Art Song Preservation Society, you know that you are supporting artists like Mark Markham today and the singers, the wonderful singers who performed, making these type of events possible. Add that we have another program tomorrow with the dramatic mezzo, Rayanne Bryce Davis, who will be doing a masterclass in dramatic interpretation of song. It starts earlier than normal at noon, so I hope that you all will check that out. The information is on our website. And lastly, later this month, we have another masterclass, this time in German Lieder, in the diction of German song. So that will be with tenor Nils Neubert. And he's marvelous, a German native who teaches at Juilliard, Manhattan School of Music, Manus, all over. Okay, well, with that, I just want to thank the wonderful singers again who were brilliant. I'd like to thank David Sexton, who makes the sound possible and us able to do this virtually. And obviously the piano tuner who comes to tune Mark's instrument, but above all, we have to thank Mark Markham. So thank you so much, Mark. Thank you, audience, for attending. And I look forward to seeing you again next time.
Merci, Mark.
Merci, au revoir. Wonderful weekend to everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.